Hello dear students, how are you all? I hope you all are fine and enjoying your online classes. My name is Manish Kumar Vishwakarma and my today's topic is from SST in history, mobile and settled communities. Today I am going to discuss with you on these topics, tribal societies, sources of information, important tribal communities. In the medieval period, society had become complex because the four varnas were further subdivided into jatis and subcastes. People following a particular profession or caste formed their own jatis. Thus, many new castes and subcastes associated with various occupations sprang up, such as weaver, goldsmith, carpenter, fisherman, and potter. Due to influence of Muslim ruler and their soldiers, a great many of our four also became they adopted their costumes and modes of dress among the Muslim to their were caste distinction. There were, however, other kind of society as well. They did neither follow the social rules and rituals described by Hindu and Muslim societies, nor were they divided into numerous unequal classes. Such societies are often called tribes and adivasis. Dear children, our next topic is tribal societies. During the medieval period, most of the tribal communities lived in dense forests, mountains, hills, deserts, etc. Their society were organized on democratic and cooperative lines. Their head was chosen collectively by the tribe for his prowess and intellect. The members of each tribe were united by kinship bond. Some of them obtained their livelihood from agriculture, others were hunter and food collector and cattle breeders. Tribes usually thrived in the forest, hills and desert area. It was not possible to an ordinary man to reach in the interior of the dense forest. They killed to retain their independent identity and preserve their own culture. Their society conditions were very poor, though they face communication problem when they come into contact with other people. Yet the forest dwellers often exchange their products such as ghee, honey, wool, medicine, herbs, etc. for grain, cotton, utensils, jewelry from the villagers. They were engaged in practicing many social evils such as child marriage and dowry. Sources of information. As the tribe led an isolated and often nomadic life, it was very difficult to know about them. Contemporary historians and travelers from the medieval period hardly give any information about the tribe, so there were no written record available. They passed their costumes and tradition from one generation to another orally. Important tribal communities. The important tribes of the medieval period were the Kokars and the Gakkars tribes of Punjab and the Laghas and Arghuns of Multan and Sindh and of the northwest, Gaddis of Himachal and Nagas, Oms of northeast and Chero of Bihar and Jharkhand and the Mundas and Santhals of Bihar, Odisha and Bengal, the Gonds of Chhattisgarh and Madhya Pradesh and Bhislin, the Rajasthan of and Madhya Pradesh, Kohlis, Briard, Kohilis. Mobile communities are comprised of nomad literates. They do not live at one place and keep on traveling. The Gypsies and Banjaras belong to the alternate group. They were similar to the warrior class of Central Asia. Even today, we can see many part of India nomads with their herds of animals. Some of the nomads were exclusively pastoral tribes. They survived on milk product and exchange ghee, wool, etc. with farmer for grain, cloth, utensil. They also transported food grain on their bullock for the armies of Gaddis and Gujars were examples of such nomads. Dear children, we will discuss on the rest of your topic in our next video. Dear children, that is all for today. Bye. Take care. Have a nice day. See you in the next class.